Hello, this video was created by Prajakta, lead information developer at BMC Software, and narrated by a computer-generated voice. This is the second video in the five-part video series to demonstrate the end-to-end configuration and working of BMC Helix Innovation Suite approval process. In the first video, we saw how to register a record definition. In this video, we will see how to configure self-approval flows. Self-approval flows are automatically approved by the system, without requiring an approver to approve them. For the onboarding use case, we want that the request should get self-approved if the summary field has the word onboarding, and the priority of the request is high. To configure self-approval flows, select the Self-Approval tab on the Edit Approval Flow screen. To create a new self-approval flow, click New Condition. In the Define Expressions tab, from the Record Definition, select Case Record Definition. Build the required expression in such a way that when the summary contains the word onboarding and the priority is equal to high, the request should get self-approved. Select summary like onboarding and priority equals to high. Now that we have built the expression, click Next. On the Select Process tab, populate the audit information. When the self-approval flow runs and the approval process is marked as approved, this message is written to the audit log. If you have a self-approval process defined, select it under the self-approval process. The self-approval process can contain the logic that the expression builder cannot execute, or you can perform additional policy checks before approving the request. For example, in the onboarding case, if the person is joining at a certain level, you may want to route this request to a process which should fetch some policy, get some results, and finally take a decision to allow or disallow this auto-approval. If the process returns a true value, then the request is auto-approved. Thank you for watching this video. In this video, we saw how to configure self-approval flows. In the third video in this series, we will see how to configure approval flows.